He was a rebel who reshaped professional football. Tonight, fans are remembering Oakland Raiders owner Al Davis. Hello, everybody. I'm Rick Chambers. Welcome to the KTLA News at 6 o'clock.
And I'm Mary Beth McDade.
Tonight, the world of pro football is remembering a true giant of the game. Al Davis, the owner of the Oakland Raiders, has died at the age of 82.
Steve Hartman, who once worked for Davis and the Raiders, is here with a look at his very colorful life. And Steve, I know you said that the man used to like to yell at you. How could anyone yell at you, Steve?
Well, he did back in the day, but he was also a dear friend. I think colorful almost understates it, because Al Davis was brilliant, innovative, stubborn, proud, combative, hyper-competitive, and as he got older, impulsive and very eccentric. But at his passing this morning at home in Oakland, my old employer, Mr. Davis, will ultimately be remembered as one of pro football's towering, unforgettable figures. Al Davis was a Jewish boy from Brooklyn, effectively was the Raiders, not just their owner, but also served as the team's de facto general manager during his entire 48-year run with the franchise. He won three Super Bowls, Super Bowls 11, 15, and 18, and was L.A.'s only Super Bowl winner in 1984. Elected to the Pro Football Hall of Fame in 1992, many believe he lost touch, especially during a streak of seven straight 11-plus loss seasons between 03 and 09. But at the end of the day, his achievements and nearly half century of longevity, the signature slogans like commitment to excellence and just win baby, far outstrip any slippage the Silver and Black have suffered in this new millennium. And tonight, there is still no official cause of death. Mr. Davis had suffered from circulatory problems. Now with his passing, three big questions instantly arise. Who will own the team? Who will run it day to day? And could this jumpstart a move back to L.A.? His heirs are his wife Carol and son Mark. Whether they want to keep the Raiders or sell them is something we'll no doubt find out in the coming months. We'll have more on the passing of Al Davis later on in Sports, guys.
Yeah, I want you to stay there and I want you to comment on a couple of things, because fans and colleagues are commenting about this on a lot of the social networking sites. Let's bring that up if we can right now. On Twitter, ESPN's Merrill Hodges tweeting, "Sad day for the NFL. Al Davis was the Elvis of football." I'll ask you about that in a second. Packers wide receiver Randall Cobb is tweeting, "The NFL lost a great today. Prayers go out to the Davis family and Raider Nation." And former Laker Shaquille O'Neal tweeted today, "Rest in peace, Al Davis. You will be missed, sir. We lost two pioneers this week." No doubt he's referring to either Steve Jobs, I'm guessing,
right,
or Chet Simmons from ESPN. What about the Elvis comparison there? No doubt the black clothing he's talking
about. Well, absolutely. Well, one of the things people did not know about Al Davis was the reason he wore black and white all the time is he was colorblind. So
really?
That way he never worried about, you know, clashing colors. He certainly had his own style. He had the pompadour. Whatever hair was left on the top of his head, he'd kind of pile it up.
He was a vain guy, though.
He was a vain guy. And in fact, we always hit it. He had a very distinctive cologne. You could smell the cologne coming a mile away with Mr. Davis. He was eccentric. There's no question about that. He had an ego. But I have to put it in perspective, because I know there's a lot of critics of Al Davis. He certainly rubbed a lot of people the wrong way. But the thing about Al is, even his fiercest critics will say, if you have a Mount Rushmore for the National Football League with the George Halases and the Paul Browns, the Vince Lombardis, Al Davis belongs.
He played a key role in what the NFL is today.
The merger of the American Football League and National Football League in 1966, in a lot of ways, was orchestrated by Al, who briefly was named the commissioner of the American Football League. He just put so much pressure on you. He was so hyper-competitive, and he did so much so early in his career, but there's no doubt. By the way, there will be a moment of silence at every NFL stadium tomorrow.
Do you think Mark and Carol are going to sell the team?
I think they're going to get a hell of an offer from AEG to bring them to Los Angeles. I don't know, but I would say it's a much bigger possibility now than when Al Davis was alive.
And just reading his bio, it's amazing just how many, you know, heads that he butted with over the years.
Well, Pete Rozelle probably retired early as commissioner of the NFL because he got tired of going back to the courtroom constantly. Al just took, you know, just he was second to nobody, and he just had such a powerful, but he was also very engaging. He was charming. There was a method to his madness and how he was able to gain the power that he did.
And he became a close friend of yours in the later years.
You know, when I left the Raider organization, working for him wasn't such a treat. But when I left him, you know, it was like over 10 years before I saw him again. I'm thinking, is he going to remember this PR guy?
Sure.
I walk up to him and I see him. I go, "Mr. Davis, Steve Harbin." He goes, Stephen, look at you. You're a big radio TV guy. And from that point on, he was a big supporter of my career. Yeah. And I certainly will miss him.
We'll talk to you more about it throughout the rest of the hour.
Steve, thank you. Ford Sports Final, presented by your Southern California Ford dealers.
We begin tonight with the passing of a true football giant, one of the NFL's most towering figures and certainly its most eccentric, Mr. Davis, Al Davis, coach, general manager, owner of the Raiders since 1963, that's 48 years, died at his home in Oakland this morning. He was 82 years old. Al Davis, a Jewish boy from Brooklyn, effectively was the Raiders. Not just their owner, but also served as their team's de facto general manager during his entire 48-year run with the franchise. He won three Super Bowls, 11, 15, and 18, and was L.A.'s only Super Bowl winner in 1984. Elected to the Pro Football Hall of Fame in 1992, many believe he lost his touch, especially during a streak of seven straight 11-loss-plus seasons between 2003 and 09. But at the end of the day, his achievements and nearly half-century longevity, the signature slogans like commitment to excellence and just win, baby, far outstrip the slippage the Raiders have suffered in the new millennium. USC head coach and former Raiders head coach Lane Kiffin said of Al Davis's death, "I was very saddened this morning to learn of the passing of Al Davis. He was an iconic figure and built a truly legendary franchise with the Raiders. I consider myself fortunate to have known him and to have been a part of that Raiders history. My thoughts go out to his family and to the family and fans of the Raiders." Well, tonight, as you look back on Al's life, remember, he hired the first Latino head coach in the NFL, Tom Flores, the first African-American, Art Shell, and he also hired the first female CEO in the league, Amy Trask. I know from my experience, he could be your enemy and then your best friend all in the same day. Owner, GM, coach, even once the commissioner of the old AFL, there was no one quite like Al Davis, and I'm guessing there never will be. All right, to hockey now in Europe, where today the Kings fell to the Sabres in Berlin 4-2. And in Stockholm, the Ducks edged the Rangers in a shootout 2-1. And later tonight, UCLA Washington State from the Rose Bowl, Rebecca Hall profiles the sensational Robert Woods, plus the ALCS game run from Texas. My commentary on why NBA players better do their math. And our brand new This Week in Sports, All When I See You with Sports Final, big half-hour show at 10:30, right after the news, guys.
Talk about the Raiders a little bit. The family still owns the team. What would you expect to see happen?
Well, Al Shearer will go to his wife, Carol, and his son, Mark. But I certainly think that there is an open discussion now that perhaps the Raiders will be on the block to be sold. And, of course, for L.A. football fans who have been dying to get a team, it could be the Raiders back, but obviously now without Al Davis. Well,
very interesting.
Everybody's watching.
Yeah, we'll be watching.
I'll have to put in a call to AEG. All right. Thanks, Steve.
Now to the death of football legend Al Davis. The outspoken owner of the Raiders died earlier this morning.
Oakland fans are remembering the man who helped shape what pro football is today.
Passing of a legend, you know. What Al Davis was able to do is unparalleled, you know.
I think it's very tragic when anybody passes away, but I hope it inspires the Raiders to be a better team and to go on and to win the Super Bowl.
He did a lot for the league. I mean, he went back probably almost 50 years now.
Many fans are also remembering Davis for being the only owner to bring a Super Bowl championship to Los Angeles.
And it's not just the local fans. The whole world of pro football tonight is remembering Al Davis.
Yes, and our very own Steve Hartman, he once worked with Davis and the Raiders. He's here with a very colorful look at his life. And Steve, I know that you happened to mention that he was a tough man to work for.
Yeah, I tell you what, there's a lot of ways to describe Al Davis. Yeah. Let's face it, I think we've heard them all. I think colorful almost understatement. You see, Al Davis was brilliant. He was innovative, stubborn, proud, combative, hyper-competitive. And as he got older, impulsive and very eccentric. But at his passing this morning at home in Oakland, my old employer, Mr. Davis, will ultimately be remembered as one of pro football's towering, unforgettable figures. Al Davis, a Jewish boy from Brooklyn, effectively was the Raiders. Not just their owner, but also served as the team's de facto general manager during his entire 48-year run with the franchise. He won three Super Bowls, Super Bowls 11, 15, and 18, and that was L.A.'s only Super Bowl winner back in 1984. Elected to the Pro Football Hall of Fame in 1992, many believe he lost touch, especially during a streak of seven straight 11-plus loss seasons between 03 and 09. But at the end of the day, his achievements and nearly half-century longevity, the signature slogans like commitment to excellence and just win, baby, far outstrip any slippage the Silver and Black have suffered in this new millennium. And tonight there is still no official cause of death. Mr. Davis had been suffering from circulatory problems. Now with his passing, three big questions instantly arise. Who will own the team? Who will run it day to day? And could this jumpstart a move back to L.A.? His heirs are his wife Carol and son Mark. And whether they want to keep the Raiders or sell them is something we'll no doubt find out in the coming months. And we're going to have much more on the passing of Al Davis later in sports.
And what most people don't know is that the NFL is the way it is today, in large part because of him.
No doubt. He helped the development of the AFL, which really, you know, they caught the vertical game and getting the ball down the field as opposed to the 3 yards and a cloud of dust ways of Lombardi's Packers. Sure. So he was able to bring in a new audience, more exciting brand of football, and that certainly carries to today.
All right, we'll look forward to what you have later on.
Absolutely, guys.
All right. Thanks, Steve. See you in a bit.
The Ford Sports Final, presented by your Southern California Ford dealers.
End of an era, baby. Hey, everyone. Steve Hartman. Glad you're here for our signature show, your Saturday Ford Sports Final. A bittersweet beginning tonight. The passing of a true football maverick, one of the NFL's most towering figures, and certainly its most eccentric. Mr. Davis, Al Davis, owner of the Raiders, coach his fact back in 1963. That's 48 years. He died at his home in Oakland this morning. He was 82 years old. Al Davis was a Jewish boy from Brooklyn. Effectively, he was the Raiders, not just their owner, but also served as the team's de facto general manager during his entire 48-year run. He won three Super Bowls, 11, 15, and 18, and was L.A.'s only Super Bowl winner in 1984. Elected to the Pro Football Hall of Fame in 1992, he was hyper-competitive, an innovator, and combative to the max, a guy who just as soon sue you as look at you. Many believe he lost touch, especially during a streak of seven straight 11-plus loss seasons between 2003 and 09. But at the end of the day, his achievements and nearly half-century longevity, the signature slogans like commitment to excellence and just win, baby, far outstrip any slippage the Raiders may have suffered in this new millennium. Mr. Davis's stature such that there will be a moment of silence before every NFL game tomorrow.